Hey, this is Camille with Nuts and Bolts Speech Training, and this is part two of the series on how to build a custom PowerPoint template from scratch, where you watch behind my shoulder as I show you exactly how I would do it. In this part two, we're going to format the content placeholders on this parent slide layout here in the Slide Master. And if you've missed part one, make sure you click on the button here on the screen so you can go back to part one and start from the beginning. Now the next step is to format the placeholders, and you can do this a number of different ways. Some people are more visual, and some people like to play around with it and see how it looks. It all depends on how you like to proceed, but I'm going to show you basically how I would do it. It's not a super scientific way, but this is how I would probably end up doing it myself. So I'm going to select this placeholder, and first things first, I'm going to change the font size to 40. I think 44 is going to be too big for this particular presentation, so I'm going to change it to 40. Then I'm going to just manually drag it here, and I'm going to give myself a bit of room beyond the bleed edges, just so that this presentation stays nice and clean. And I'm going to think, I'm going to leave it about here. I might drag it down a tiny bit. I'm also going to shrink it. Let's see, actually, I'm going to drag the text to be at the bottom. So I'm actually going to go in here in the paragraph area, select align to bottom. The reason that I do this is because I want all the text to stay around here, and as text gets added, so for example, if I continue to type a title and it goes to the second line, as you can see, etc., I want everything to stay aligned to this bottom line here. If I had it aligned middle or top, let me just show you an example, right? So if the next slide, if it keeps going, everything's going to be aligned to here. Whereas if I had set it to middle, as this grew, you'll notice the text actually jumps, and I don't want it to jump. So I'm just going to Control Z to undo all of that. So that is why I align it to the bottom. I almost always align to bottom because I don't like my titles to jump around from slide to slide. But in some situations, align to middle makes sense, especially if you know they're going to be very short titles all the time. All right, so once I've done that, I want to I'm going to type in more text just randomly to see how it looks with two lines of text. You can try as you want to get people to only write short titles. It won't happen typically. So I'm just going to adjust it based on how I think someone might end up putting two lines of text here. I want to be prepared for that eventuality. So I will then delete all this dummy text, and that's going to be roughly where my text placeholder is going to be. I'm trying to decide, I'm going to want some empty white space here. So I might just drag this to about here, just for stylistic effect. So once that's done, I'm actually going to drag one of these guides down. So I'm going to select Control, drag one down so that it matches here. And actually, there we go. And now I'm going to just realign this here, make sure that they're nice and neat. Once I've done the top, I'm going to do the bottom as well. I'm basically going to put guides on all of this because I want to make sure that we have everything set in case anything moves down the road. Again, Control, drag this here. Sometimes it's helpful to zoom in and drag another one out here. So now I have my layout. Actually, I think this is going to be a little much. I'm going to drag this to maybe here and expand this. You'll notice once I have guides also, it makes it easier to drag and align things because PowerPoint has smart guides, which set immediately to this guide. So that's another reason that these guides are handy. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is edit this content placeholder. And again, this is going to apply to all of your slide layouts. So you want to make sure that you set it for the general look and feel. You can then edit these further down the road. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to drag this to the side. And look, it happens to fit perfectly already there. And I'm going to give myself maybe a little less space. Let's see. Drag it to about there. Then I'm going to add my guides again, so I'm just going to add one. Oops, I forgot to hit Control. Let me place it back up here. Control. My mouse is being funny. Control, drag. All right, and then I think I might even drag this a little bit further down, and I will add the guide, Control, and drag. Let's add it about there. And I will drag this. So now you can see this doesn't look exactly aligned. Let me make sure I adjust it. There you go. So now you can see we have our general framework set up. It looks like I moved this rectangle in the back inadvertently. Now, this brings up a good point, actually, of something that I will want to do before I finalize my presentation, and I'm not actually going to do it quite yet because I want to first double check everything, but before we finalize this presentation, this template, excuse me, we're going to want to make sure that we save this background as something that's not necessarily easy to edit for someone down the road. So once you've decided on it, you want to make sure that someone doesn't inadvertently do what I just did, which is move things around and then not realize they did it and find out later and wonder what the heck that's doing there. So I'm going to control Z to undo that. But we'll do that at the very end so that we still have some room to maneuver in case we want to change anything. And so actually that brings up one last point, which is that I'm going to add another guide to this edge just in case this gets moved and I want to make sure that I know how to replace it. So I will have that extra guide right there. Okay, so now that we have this laid out, we are going to edit this content placeholder. I actually am going to change everything to be a little bit smaller. So I'm going to change this top level to 20 because this presentation is going to be delivered in a small setting. So the next one will be 18. The following one will be 16. And I will make the last two the same size, 14, because I don't want anyone to type anything smaller than 14. So this gives you a sense of the font size. I'm also going to adjust the bullet a little bit. In fact, I'm going to make all of these bullets square. And I'm also going to bring, maybe I'll bring some of these a tad closer. Control Z, I don't like that. I'll just bring that one closer. This one closer, and this one closer. Okay, so, and in fact, now that I'm here, I'm thinking I might even bring this a tad closer as well. This is just personal preference, okay? So you can adjust this however you like. Oops. And based on your knowledge of how someone is going to be using this template, you might decide to add more space, less space, etc. I am assuming that someone is not going to be using a whole lot of these lower levels, so but I still want to have them formatted in case someone does, because what happens if you delete, say, these last levels and someone types in and tries to go to the next level, it's going to default back to the original Office formatting, which is not going to work with your template. So my recommendation, as is Julie's and Echo's, is to always make sure that you format to the furthest extent that you can so that you have at least something set if someone breaks the rules or decides to do their own thing, which inevitably happens with templates. So now that I have these two main placeholders set, I'm going to set the footers as well. And these footers, I'm actually going to make a size 10. I think that is going to be enough. I like the fonts and the colors already of the text, so I'm not going to make any changes to that. I am going to change the positioning of them. So the first thing I'm going to do is select, I'm going to zoom in a bit here so I can see this more clearly. Oops. I'm going to drag this slide number placeholder down, and I'm going to make it fit to the guide here. And I'm going to make this a lot smaller because even if we were to type, say, slide number 200, which hopefully doesn't get to, but you never know, then I have plenty of room for that. So I'm going to hit Control-Z to undo. I'm actually going to drag it a little bit smaller here. And I'm going to put a little stylistic design element here, which is a bar. And I will add a couple spaces. And so let's just test this out, actually. Test this out if we make bar and then 200, 299. We still have lots of room. What if we added a second space, 299? We don't have room. So this is a good thing to do. Always just test, see what it looks like with an extreme situation. And so that's what I'm going to do. So I will hit Control-Z to undo all of that. and drag this out a little bit. Add the bar, space, two spaces, maybe three, and see how that looks. I think that looks pretty good. The other thing that I'm going to do is I'm actually going to adjust this placeholder by right-clicking it, format shape, and I'm going to go to paragraph options here, text box options, and I'm going to remove the left margin so that I can really get down to the very edge of it. That way, when I drag my date placeholder over here, I can really get very close to it. So I'm going to drag this about here, drag this down to match, and I'm going to hit Control R to align the text to the right, and now you can see I have some good spacing. I'm just going to adjust this a little bit so that I have the date right next to the page number. Then I'm going to go in here and go into the Insert tab, click on Header and Footer, and I'm going to adjust the date and time, and I actually am going to make it December 30th, 2017, hit Apply, Apply to All, and now it's adjusted. Okay, this doesn't look like it's perfect. Let me make sure it is. There we are. And to triple check, I can always go to Drawing Tools Format tab, check the height, 035, 035. So we're good. Okay, now we've set the slide number and the date. I'm actually going to make this date a little bit shorter because I don't need that much room. And finally, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the footer. And before I can set the footer, what I need to do is actually figure out how much room I have here, because I'm going to want to put my logo here on the left. So before I touch the footer, I'm actually going to go and I'm going to insert my logo. Now, once I have my logo copied, I'm going to hit Control V to paste it in. Now make sure you paste it in as a PNG, not as a JPEG, because a PNG will not lose its quality over time, whereas a JPEG will. So I'm going to paste it in, I'm going to drag it down, I'm going to make this way smaller, this is much too big. And let me just adjust it here to my guides, and I might just make it a fair bit smaller here. I think that looks right. Actually, I can make it the same height as my footer, so 035. And I'm going to align it to my guides again. Make sure I have that set. My smart guides are helping me out here, even though my mouse is being touchy. Okay, so now that we have it in place, I have a bit of sense of how much room I have for my footer. So I'm actually going to drag my footer out here, and I'm going to align it to the bottom and the top of my other placeholders. And I'm actually going to hit Control L to align the footer to the left so that it's next to the logo and continues out towards the right. So now I have my footer set up. This gives me room in case someone wants to put a tagline or some other text down below, maybe an author, maybe some kind of source cited. So again, it's just like the bullet level here that I mentioned earlier. I want to keep these and I want to make sure they're formatted, because someone is possible, even though in this situation I'm not sure there's going to be a footer, someone might want to add it, and you want to make sure that it's formatted or else it's going to revert back to the default and look very ugly. So again, make sure that you have everything that's given to you formatted and there for someone to use. You can always remove it individually per layout or give instructions to someone to not use it. Now, before I finalize this, I'm actually going to add one last guide. I'm going to, using the Control key, drag this down. And hopefully it fits. Let's see. Please let me select it. I feel like recently it's gotten harder to select these. Let's see. Looks like PowerPoint wants it to put it there, so I'm going to adjust. Rather than pulling my hair out, I'm just going to adjust the footer to match. There we are, and last one, so that it fits. Okay, So now we have our basic framework set up for this PowerPoint template. We have the parent slide layout that is fully formatted. We have the background design elements. We've got the content placeholders, including the title, the main content area. We've got our logo, our footers. Everything is laid out, and we've got our guides to tell us exactly where things are positioned. And now we can move on and edit the individual child layouts within this PowerPoint template. So if you're ready to move on to the next part of this PowerPoint template and finish it off, click on the button here on the screen to go to part 3. Otherwise, this is Camille from Nuts and Bolts Speed Training, and I will see you at Happy Hour.